didn't follow the hatchlings very far, but they believe that 1 in 1,000 becomes an adult. Now, we found out from our statistics that when we first started, of all the eggs that were laid, only 37% hatched and got back to the sea. But with our project, we've now got that up to 80%. So they've got more than twice the survival rate than there used to be. But then I'm also a director of the Marine Trust and work with the local fishermen. And when they realised that the fish were eating the turtles out at sea, they said, why are you letting them go at night? Why don't you let them go in the day? And I said, well, why? And they said, because the big fish that eat them have all now gone out into the deep water. So we let them go in the daytime. And it means instead of losing 95% of the nest from the nest to the ocean, we actually now only lose about 5%. So not only have we doubled the survival rate of eggs hatching, but the survival rate is massively more. And the university think we're somewhere between 1 in 20, 1 in 30 have a chance of coming back as adults.
What an extraordinary job you're doing. How many are there in the team?
Right. When you get a nest here, and we've got one that we're digging up just behind me here, that the turtles will lay between 100 and 240 eggs in a nest. And that depends how old they are, how mature they are. But at the same time, what then happens is, you get sort of predators on land, you get the predators at sea. So what we're trying to do is to stop all the things that we control, but keep it as natural as possible.
And are you going to release some this morning, did we hear?
We are, yeah.
Can we see?
I just turned to Omar. Can you pass me one? Omar's just taken them out of the nest and they're in the bucket. You can see Omar just behind me. He'll bring one of the hatchlings over so I can show you what they look like close up. He'll be a second or two and he'll do that.
All right, don't worry.
That's all right.
That's absolutely fine. Did you ever imagine you'd be spending your retirement doing this?
No. When we came to Jamaica, my wife and I, we were going to set up a small guest house. We managed to buy a property that overlooked the beach. And so consequently, the guest house seemed a really good idea. And then turtles really took over. But also, the main road outside was being redeveloped as the North Coast Highway, and it took them 4 years to get from digging it up to putting asphalt down. And so we really couldn't open up as a guest house, but then in that time, the turtles started to happen. So here's the first one. Hang on, let's find the camera.
So sweet.
There you go.
Now, it's covered in sand. Now, what we do is we normally wash them, and then what we're looking at is for the belly button to make sure it's healed, because they've grown off an egg, and at different parts of the nest they incubate at different rates, and so consequently some of them may not be fit to go to sea. If they're not, we've built an incubator upstairs that's out of an old deep freeze, and we cook them for a couple of days at 30 degrees and then they're perfect condition to be released.
Way
we save more. Also, when you get nests in the wild, the turtles dig themselves out. From when they hatch out of the shell, it takes them 3 days to dig to get to the surface, and then they cross the beach. So it gives them time to heal.
Yeah.
But if they haven't healed properly, or they're right at the bottom of the nest, you could find 4 or 5 dead turtles when you open up the nest. But the way that we do it, it means that every turtle that hatches survives.
Can you, we're going to call that one Davina. Can you release Davina into the sea?
We're going to do a whole lot. We've got about 100 or so behind us.
Oh.
So what we're going to actually do in a few minutes is we'll put it down, or when you tell me, we'll put it on the beach and you can watch them walk across.
Well, we'll let you get set up, we've got a couple of other things to do. So if you get yourself all set up, and then we'll watch them be released. Is that all right, Mel?
No problem at all.
Right, we'll be back with you in 4 or 5 minutes.